Hey, it's on. Hi. I'm trying to get to that Black Mountain there, which is actually a volcanic cinder cone. I've been walking a long ways. You can see humanity off out there, about there in the distance. It's far away. I'm probably 4 miles, 3 miles from my car, which is parked. Let's see if I can zoom in on it. It's parked beside that white building there. You can maybe see a glint of glass off to the right. And so I had to come up through the desert, up the canyon wash there, and I couldn't find it. I was looking for volcanic evidence. I climbed up here, and I began to see. Hold the camera steady, dude. See if I can find any cinders. Hold on, do this right. See if I can find any volcanic cinders. I started to see intermittent little, as I was climbing a little hill there. There. Hey, this is one right here. This is a cinder. It's a big one. You see the holes in it? Yeah, this is probably ejected from a volcanic cone nearby. There's probably more if I look around. Looking for the little telltale holes. Lots of interesting rocks. Boy, I could spend a whole weekend just sitting here, sitting amongst these rocks, reading all the stories that they have to tell. See, not a lot. This is one. That's a big one. This is a volcanic rock. This is a igneous rock. And probably expelled explosively from that cinder cone over there, which is probably a mile and a half away. Let's zoom in. So I'm gonna have to get over there, cross the desert, and I'm gonna try to summit that Black Mountain and be all those volcanic rocks when I get over there. But I'm gonna have to go over one, two, maybe three valleys of these desert washes to get there. And then what I'll do is once I reach it, I'll summit that, and then I'll come back down and go across the desert back to the car, and hopefully have enough time for daylight for the whole thing. I'd love to go up in there, but just not enough time. So here we go, let's cross the desert. Isn't this a nice wash? So I came up for the first little wash that I have to get down inside of, and you can see how the flash floods would come racing through here. You can see the braided course of the stream as it goes by. And we're seeing, even just a few feet further, we're seeing more of these big rocks that were expelled from the volcano. I'm sure we'll see a lot more as we get closer. And there's another little stream up there. Very nice. Really wish I could get up there. I wish there was time. Maybe a camping expedition would be good. I think I'll go down this way. Maybe a camping expedition. Come up here with my tent and my backpack and all that kind of stuff. And sleep up here. I should scope out some campsites. This is BLM land, so that's fine. Just need to get a campfire permit. And I'll be all set. Okay. Well, I'll tell you, buying this Steadicam was a great investment, although I didn't use it very much in Japan because of the many trees that were always getting in the way when I was hiking. Out here in the desert, it's just perfect. Look at that big, beautiful rock right there. So much pleasure that comes from the study of geology. I'm glad I've got some time to enjoy that a little more in my life. And contrary to my usual principle of never taking anything, I've begun to take samples of rock. I guess you would call that ore samples. Back to my home so that I can study them. You know, interesting composition, and then come back and look it up and try to find samples that match it and learn about the history and the geology of it all. Nice sandy wash. Interesting plants that grow down here. It's a different biozone. Some of the plants are the same, but some of them are quite unique. I've seen lots of interesting ant nests. I think it's washed out a little bit down here. I always like to see the wash cuts where they reveal the rocks, which I have yet to really get my mind working on what this is. Whether this is a landslide, part of the mountain, or just what. Looking at the composition like this, the loose composition of just here, there, and everywhere rocks that are mostly, there are rounded ones, but a lot of them are not rounded, so which leads me to believe that this may be a giant landslide or a mudslide. I think I'll try to get up. Not there, that'll be hard. I'll try to climb up over here. Yeah, that'll be better. Always on the lookout for snakes and all those things. I'll just climb right up here. The camera off now so I can keep both hands. Guess that's it. Here we go. Okay, I'm back up on the other side. You can see the cone of the cinder cone's head peeking just above the ridge there. There's a really big ant mound right there. Look at that. Although I'm not seeing too much ant activity. Might be a little cold. Maybe as they warm up. I guess it's warming up. There are ants. Because they deposit all the seeds and stuff along there. Okay, this little wash doesn't look like it's going to be quite so difficult. Look at this, the exfoliation. The bits and pieces have chipped off, fallen away. Oh, there's another bit from the volcano. Should be seeing a lot more of them as we get closer. There's some right there. These, yeah. All these rocks are here. Scared the dickens out of a coyote earlier. It was sleeping under a bush or didn't hear me coming. It couldn't hear me coming. That's why I thought it was asleep. What a noise that I make. It took off running. I was very close when it startled it. Maybe it was just hiding, hoping I wouldn't see it. But chance just brought me that close. Ooh, there's a nice one. Gee. You know, that almost looks like a meteorite. My friend John was telling me about how to carry a magnet and to look for burn marks. Doesn't it look like it's like falling through the atmosphere? How heavy is it? If it was a meteorite, iron, and have an iron sound. I don't know. I can't tell. I'm going to leave it like this. So if I come back with my magnet, I can check it out again. I wonder if that's what a meteorite looks. See, this is what the lava that came out and spewed out looked like, but it's been broken perhaps. But doesn't it look like it's been, it's got more, it's not as textured, it's smoother. Interesting. I don't know. Yeah, that's the kind I would expect to see out of a volcano. Lots of it. Look at all the volcanic rocks now. We're only, you know, maybe an eighth of a mile, a quarter of a mile from where we started the video. We're already seeing a lot more volcanic rocks. Okay, I'll turn off for a second. Oh, okay, now we're down into the third wash. And I thought it would be just three or four washes to the volcano. This is going to be, you know, more like six or seven, I think. Okay, time to my volcano rock. Time to cogitate. Get the old thinking cap on with regard. Look at that. Look at that rock. It's a sedimentary rock laid down in layered deposits that have unfolded in nice concentric rings. Look at this rock. All beat up in place. So, think about this. What is this? I don't think this is mountain. I think this is landslide. Or gradual wearing away of the mountains. I'm pretty sure that these mountains are very old and worn down. And that's what contributes to this great plain out here. This incredible expanse of open desert out here. City size. You could fit San Bernardino Valley in there. Los Angeles out there. Maybe one day it will. Oh, and look at that. Look at the great Providence and Granite Mountains off there in the distance. Pretty sure that that range there to the right, that's the granite, those are the granites. And then I don't know what these are, but I think that's the Providence Mountains out there. And yeah, I would lay my amateur claim. Here we go. Four, at least four or five there. Let's go down here. A landslide. Almost like and then a braided stream is coming, braided its way across the top. Okay, turn off for a second. I actually came back down. I thought this would be, let's compose this shot. Look at that plant. Let's compose this shot, because I come up and you can see the dramatic cap of the cinder cone up there. Here we go. Pretend like this is the first time. Oh, wow, look at that cinder cone there. Amazing. Definitely closer. So I think that was 1, 2, 3, 5 so far. And here we go, let's do number 6. And more rocks here. What's that sound? Just the empty mind of the desert. Okay. Now the debris here is becoming very composed very composed. Lots and lots of stones from the volcano. From the cinder cone. Here, let's drop down in. Okay, camera goes off. Okay, we're back up. Another one? I lost track of how many now. You'd notice you kicked that thing, wouldn't you? Ow. Get an idea about the size. Put my hand next to it. Not too close though. Okay, let's have a good bit of an expansive plane here. Gotta watch out for those cactus. Kick, there's another one there. Kick those, and that'll be ow. And they can lose their joints. So they can be anywhere. More volcanic rock. That's becoming largely volcanic rock everywhere. The cone is quite prominent now. Let's get a photo of that. Photo. Oh, good, I can see the end. Now, some things to think about with this are the composition of that hill over there, the white one that comes off of it. I wonder if that's made of ash. Probably not. Kind of built up here. I wonder what we'll find up there. Because there's different types of material that can be belched from a volcano like this, from a cinder cone like this. We'll have to try and reconcile what we see with what we know. Sorry, off steady cam for a second. I got the one hand free. Whoa. Yep. Maybe this is the second to last one. Hi. Who cares? You don't want to see me. Another photo. Let's get one with the area up there and up there. Two photos. You can see the shiny surface. The volcanic rock. Now you can see this is what we typically see. All these small stones down there, these are cinders. And the desert has made them into this desert pavement. This is not the best desert pavement I've ever seen, but it's a good one. You know, these are made through wind, drops the sand here, water drops materials down, and microseismic activity causes the sand to fall between the stones and below. And then the stones slowly rise, staying at the top, while the sand is deposited in ever younger and younger. You know what I mean? Oldest stuff on the bottom, newest stuff at the top. Deposit. So it's like a blanket. The stones are like a blanket. So these stones have probably been laying here in place since that volcano erupted. Oh, jackrabbit. Did you guys see it? That's what it was like with the coyote over there. And they have a varnish, a gloss that grows on them, that develops. You can see it right there. See how dull it is on this side and shiny it is? Well, that's a different color. Let's see if we can find another one. There's one. See the color there? Kind of shiny. And then, well, you can't tell. It's dirty. Dull. But this shininess is from the sparse rain that rot deposits here. And bits and minerals are deposited that make this shiny surface. And then you don't have it on the bottom, although it's hard to see because it's dirty. And that's the way it works. But these have probably been exposed and in place, these rocks, since that volcano erupted, which could be, you know, I'm taking a guess based on estimates of age of nearby volcanoes, cinder cones, of about 10,000 to 20,000 years ago. Interesting to think that these rocks may have been in place ever since. There's a beautiful view of the valley. Wow, I'm glad that it brought us over here. This is splendid. Would you look at that? There's a rabbit. See it right there? standing up. Let's get a photo. Photo, snap. Snap. See if it runs. There it goes. That's just what it was like with the coyote earlier. Running through the desert. Oh, that's the second airplane I've heard today. Look at this wash. Nice, look at the expanse here. Joshua tree, I think those are Joshua trees, this type of yucca. Spotty here and there, out there. That might be a good place to camp right over there. No signs of humanity at all. There goes the jackrabbit, still running like crazy. Up the canyon, it's hard for me to zoom in. It's gone. Just, sorry. I hate doing that to animals because they have, especially in environments like this, they have little bits of fat reserves. So when they do that, they expend a lot of energy, for nothing. I'm not going to hurt them. They need to get away from the coyotes. But then the coyotes need a meal. Okay, see that white bit in front? That looks different. Or maybe not. I'll see, it's kind of darker over here. Looks different. That could be something else. We'll have to look at it. Let's look closely at this. You can see all the rocks. Lots of different rocks from a lot of volcanic rocks, but a lot of different rocks from different composition. There's different igneous rocks there. I've seen a few sedimentary rocks, but mostly it's kind of the mix and match. Most of these probably washed down from the older mountains up there. So we'll see what kind of composition we have over there. Wouldn't surprise me if we saw mines, but no, there wouldn't be a mine in a volcano. Are you going to mine for more volcano? Look at the sharp line of the volcano comes down. Right there. That's beautiful. Very distinctive desert. Topographic feature. Well, I got to get down here. It's going to be a bit of a slide, so I'm going to turn the camera off as I... Well, leave it on. Here we go. Rough slide. It's one-handed. This is pretty tricky. I can easily take a tumble. Okay, I think we should take a close look at this. Look at the composition of this hill, which I think is a mud or landslide. We'll see if we see the same composition over there. I have a feeling it's going to be a little finer texture. Maybe something called volcanic tuft or tuff. I'm going to put a T-E-E-N. Okay, we made it. And here's one of those nice yucca plants. Aren't they beautiful? Not me. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's cross the wash. This is not where you'd want to be when a flash flood came. See all the channels where the water comes down, and there's nowhere to run. There's no high ground out here. And literally a wall of water could come down moving at the rate of a slow-moving automobile. Whatever that means. You can see where the water came down through here. Oh, I can see a barrel cactus over there. Let's go visit that. Or at least it looks like, maybe it's not a barrel cactus, but I can't remember. Still, it's like waking up from a dream after being in Japan so long. The life out here is a mystery to me. But it's funny because I used to know what it was. So now see all the rocks out here? These are not volcano rocks. I mean, they're igneous rocks for the most part. They are from, magma intrusions in the deep earth. These are all washed down from the mountains up there, where they had a very different geologic origin, and versus the volcanic rocks here that were spewed out, belched out from this volcano. Here we are. This could be a barrel cactus. I don't know. Another nice cactus here. Oh, steady, Kurt. Ooh, right there. Let's go look at this. There's an old ant colony that's all buried in. Isn't life fascinating? There's just so much to see out here. Even though the desert's not going to tell us anything, we can use our minds, the sentience we've developed, to make some sense of it and not get poked by one of these. Ouch. Okay, more of the same. So this clearly has the same geologic origin as that what we were over there, and very similar to what we see in the wash. So all of those things we've been coming over are all definitely from the mountains. Don't kick that. Now let's go see what this is. And then we've got the volcano. Cinder cone. It's going to turn into a long video, I think. Creosote bushes. Ah, pencil choya. Nice. I'm pretty sure this is a pencil choya. Kind of looks like a pencil. Those cactuses we were seeing were choya too. You gotta watch out, they'll drop their little things around here and get stuck on your foot. And these really hurt. They poke you. Sometimes even just experimental touches will get you. I think that's the fruiting element right there. Pencil choya. Nice. Kind of a new choya for me. Even though I've done a lot of hiking out here, I don't remember seeing those a lot. Largely because the hiking that I was doing in the desert up here was in a different area. Deeper still into the desert. Okay. Well, now as we get closer, this is looking more and more suspicious like what we saw before. Isn't it? Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, this is the same. So, no big deal there. Probably more of the same. These Badland Hills. Should we go this way around or this way around? The path of wildness is telling me to go this way. Although it would be nice to go around that way and then go. If we did that, that would make more sense because go up that way and then back that way. Yeah, that way we. Oh, hey, footprints! if we did that, then we would have. It's interesting to be in a place where there's no human, no signs of humanity, no footprints, nothing. Just these contrails and sounds of a few airplanes. So I gotta go off steady cam for a second. Arms tired. It's a very nice area. Ooh, looks very nice up there. Pretty green, too. The cinder cone. Wow, that looks a lot more challenging to climb than I had initially thought. I'm kind of tired. Still a long ways from the car. Kind of see where the car is, I think. I think that's where it is. Anyway, it's that direction. So much for my idea. Okay. I think we should go around the volcano. Well, let's go check that out and then we'll go around the volcano and then up to the top. I'll probably turn the camera off in just a moment. We'll go see what the composition of this white stuff is. Although I'm pretty sure now that we are dealing with the same stuff that we had before. Which would indicate that this volcano rose up through one of those formations, because it looks like that goes right smack dab into the volcano. More pencil choya. First, rock really looks like it. Look at that welded stuff on there. Of go to the very edge of the volcano here, check it out, and then we'll start going around and then up. A little disappointed. I was hoping this would be a bit of volcanic ash, but now that you think about it, I don't necessarily know that this kind of volcano makes that. This is definitely just the same stuff we saw before. So this is the old mountain, and here's the new mountain. Here's the rocks from the volcano. I should have been taking more photos as I was going. Look at that, the green on there. Isn't that nice? Okay, now there's black widows living all over in here, so I gotta be careful about that. They're probably hidden away now for the night. I'm actually on the volcano now. The cinder cone. That could be a black widow's web right there. I see it coming down from here, all the way down. Let's see if I can see the hole there. It looks like a black widow's web. There's another web over there. See the web right there? Pretty typical for what black widows do. Okay. Alright, we made it to the volcano. Okay. It's going to be making me a little crazy. Good thing. Okay, I'll turn the camera on as we see more interesting stuff. Okay, you can see where part of it is collapsed in. You can see, whoa, ouch. You can see different material down there. This must be the original material from the volcano, the cinder cone pushed through. It's like a more, you know, cooled magma. It's hard to tell. I don't know, this is very interesting. Someone with more and better knowledge of geology might be able to fill in about what this is. Green would lead me to think there's copper in there. Lots of quartz right there. Looks like it cooled at the margin of a magma chamber. Could this be like a copper? Copper deposit, maybe? Sorry, I'm not doing good with the camera. Okay, I am going to climb to the top of this thing, but I think we'll walk around the base first. Oh, another nice pencil choy. Look at the light coming through that. There's a little rock rolled up. Look at the redder bits up there. I wonder what causes that redder bit. Need more iron. Volcano with more iron. Darker. Here. Nice cactus. Why this is so black in comparison. Look at the sharp, that sharp distinction. Like that. Okay, off for a second. Okay, we're coming up to an interesting landscape up here. Kind of intimidating a little bit. You know, I don't know what it is, but it just feels kind of awkward up here. Invariably that feeling comes to nothing. I get it sometimes, and that's nothing. Someday it'll be something, and then I'll say, see that feeling. But look at that dark, shadowy spot up there, leaning to that. What is that up there? What's up there? What's lying in wait? And look at that dark band. Let's go find out. I love this amazing, sharp distinction here. This line. Let's see the photos. Photos. But that's what I come here for. Okay, let's stop for a second. Whoops, I didn't realize the camera was on for the last 10 minutes. Oh well. So anyway, here we go. I think I'll cut that out because it was just me dancing and singing and all kinds of stuff. Here I am in a spooky place. I was actually scared of this coming up. I didn't turn the camera on though. I'm going up this, following the volcano, and I kind of forgot about the camera. And I was getting up there and my mind was distracted. Oh, all kinds of things I didn't show you guys. What is this? Look at that. That's a, probably related to that. That's a, see that? That's a sedimentary rock deposit. Let's go back a little bit. So I want to show this to you guys. See all the same old rocks you've been seeing before, but we're starting to see some different stuff. In addition to this beautiful lava wall over here, it's got to be 60 to 80 feet tall in places. Making me wonder if this was a lava flow and if the cinder is somewhere else. Looks like right here we have a little outcropping of, what is that, like maybe just a little, a rift or something like that of lava there? Possibly. You know, just a little bit sticking out the side. It feels better having you guys around. It was kind of scary there for a little bit. Oh, here's what I wanted to show you. This right here. Oh, and that down there. See, I like that. This is more of that outcropping. There's a geologic principle related there. It's getting late. I need to mind the time because I've got a long hike back. Can you hear the edge of my voice? It's a little bit spooky out here now, especially since I'm deep in, deep over. Pretty sure I've got a pretty good shot back to the car, but you know, still, look at these, isn't this great? This one kind of deposit here, and then the different types. We got the volcanic stuff over here, and then this other stuff here. What is this? This is volcanic ash. Yeah, I would bet my just about my geologic degree, which I don't have, that this is volcanic ash. I think I'll take that little sample home after I beat the heck out of it. So, could that be what that is? Layered volcanic ash. Let's take a photo of that, and then the lava. Okay, I'll turn the camera on as we get back up to that point. Here we go. Oh, hi. Let me show you something else I just found. I stopped and just did an Instagram photo. By the way, I sound like a promo. I usually don't do that, but I do a lot of social media. A lot of photographs and social media. I think that these are ripple marks, maybe from a stream. First, I thought they were just like sedimentary layers, but you can see the layers there. And look at the marks. They don't quite look like sedimentary layers, do they? They kind of, you know, one after another. The flow of the stream would have been from right to left. And from here, let's see if we can get a better place with the shadows. Where you can see the lines better there. That's pretty good. Is it? Come on, Kurt, get it right. There you go. Hey, it doesn't look like white. Ah, and you can kind of see it there from the up here to the down here would have been the flow. Very nice. Put that there. Now let's go up here. Wow, look at this. Lava. I zoomed out. Good. The photo. Yay. Oh, should I take a photo of that? Yeah. Let's take a photo of that too. That's a nice. See down there, it's different. See, it's different there. So I think that laid down. This is the tuff from the volcano, the volcanic material. There, that's good. Photo. So I think it may have been from this volcano that laid down the ash that fell into the river, which if it was 10 to 20,000 years ago would have been the Pleistocene. This would have been the cooler, wetter place, and then formed the ripple marks that got turned into stone. And here it is, the tuff deposit
careful, Kurt. You can see it's all laid down. See the strata? I don't want to get up there too close to it. I don't want any bits to fall on me so far away. I wonder if we'd find any fossils in here. Probably not if it's tough. But, you know, goodness gracious. Fascinating. Look at that. You can see the same type of thing. I don't see those stream layers, but... Okay, so we have tuff on one side and volcanic rock on the other. Interesting. Isn't that a Beatles song, The Walls of Tuff? Ooh, it's cold here in the shadows. Let's get up here. Let's get up on the volcano. Let's go around the corner here. I can't believe I was afraid of this place back there. The little demons in my voice, in my head. You know, the old brain saying, don't go any place new or different. You'll die. There's agency up there. You don't want to have none of that agency. That's what we do. We attribute the unknown to forces. Look at that. To forces malevolent or kind. Anyway, forces that have a mind and a will and a purpose for us. When we barely have a mind and will and purpose for ourselves. I just did a poem, if I can call it such, just a moment ago. Something about the desert sentience. Is it bad form to read your own poetry in the video? Let's see. I'll read it to you guys. If I could find it first. The desert mind. There it is. There's no perceptible sentience in the desert. It's an empty mind where hard facts and reality don't give a damn what I think. And I stand by it. Without saying unequivocally. Look at this. Mud. Very nice. Yeah, it's still soft. Okay, I think this is going to give us... This is green. Look at that. I think that green... Ooh! I know what that is. I know what that green is. Is there any more of it? Pull that up. It's too heavy. I know what that is. That's a bit of the inside of the mantle of the earth. I mean, the inside of the lower crust of the earth. Fascinating. I gotta turn the camera off and get a photo of that. Okay, we're back on. I remember what that's called. I think it's called the moho, which the moho is the very bottom of the earth's crust. And it can get, bits of that can get pulled up when magma from the crust, from the inside of the earth, rises through volcanic vents like this. I've only heard about it, but I've never seen it. Always wanted to see it. And there we go. That's a nice run. Okay, I don't think I'll go up there. I think I'll scramble up here. Here we go. Scramble together. Scramble, scramble. That would have hurt if I'd gone a little further. Sorry for the little camera action. This is hard. Oh, crud. It's getting harder as they get up. Ouch. Danger. Getting a little bloody here. Hope that rock doesn't give out. And that was hard. Oh, look at that. I'm on the ball. That was hard. Probably not the smartest move. See the caves over there? I think those are lava tubes. I mean, the worst that would have happened if I'd slid, is I would have scraped up my knees. But I survived. Let's go up here and take a look over the other side. And then we'll go out on the volcano, have lunch, and then down the other side. Okay, note to self. A little more careful.
stuff slippery. Nice. See the lava? Am I repeating myself? Right there. And then something out there is like a bird of prey. Can you guys see it? Or something. Okay, let's go up here and have a look. Well, there wasn't any danger. Nice. But, you know, a place like this, you don't want to take chances here in that slippery spot. Okay, I'm going. I'm going to go up here over, take a peek over the edge. It's always nice to see what's a little further. Way the hell out here. More volcanoes, I can see. Holy crap. Jeez Louise. Holy crap. Terror coming over me now. It's a terror of the friggin' wilderness. I'll go up here and get a look. I won't get too close on my bike. Holy sh! Excuse my language, I didn't say it. Look at that canyon down there. That gorge. I gotta find a way out there. I gotta find a way in there. Holy crud. That's all volcanic stuff. That's all volcanic stuff over there. Not over here. There's old mountains. All. There must be volcanic cinder cones all over the place. And then you can see them extending way out there. See the volcanic? Those are actual volcanoes over there. Let's see if we can get them. I've been out there. Let's see if I can zoom in on them. That roar you're hearing is a train. In the distance, that's a volcano. Or is that it? That it? Yeah, that's a volcano. And that whole black area, there's cinder, lava fields. And you can see the train. You want to hear the roar? There's the train way down there. Very long. My hand's shaking.
Crap. Okay, I'm gonna have lunch here. Turn off the camera. Is this thing on?
Yeah.
Okay, I beat it the heck out of there. I couldn't take it. I just wrote in my journal that I went to a place today where the wilderness looks back. You know, I'm not into any of that woo stuff, but I really did feel like the whole wilderness was had, you know, kind of looked. I had come up over the rise there, and the whole wilderness kind of went, and was looking at me like I definitely didn't belong. Wow, my heart hasn't gone like pitter-patter like that in a long time. I don't think I was in any real danger. I'm still a long ways away from the car, but I think I'll be able to get there quicker because I'm going on a more direct route. But the problem is, coming from a direction that I didn't come from before. So maybe that sense I had over there, there's something to it. That old brain winning out. You know, that old, you know, that chants over the fires and, you know, makes amulets of power and wards away spirits. I mean, it's a part of my brain. It served a purpose and I can't get it out. And now I have to say that it was warning me about going up there. And there certainly was something to it. But like, I don't know if I said it in fact or if I just said it out loud while camera was off. You know, that happens over and over, that premonition, and then nothing happens, and then you don't think about that, but then finally something happens, you're like, oh, see? But still, it's nothing more than a narrows where it's a little bit scary, and then a sight that was truly terrifying, just in its sheer scope and compass. Okay, I'm going to turn this off. I think this hike's over. My goal now, contrary to what I'm doing, is to make a slow and steady hike, careful footsteps, all the way out of here. It's very dark. It's going to get very cold here when the sun goes down. And I'm ashamed to say that I don't have good warm clothes, and I didn't leave word with anybody where I am. Oh, there's a plastic, my arch nemesis. Come here, you. Stuck to the rock. Stupid plastic. Never goes away. Carry that out of here. So that was done. Don't attempt this at home. Okay. Compose my thoughts and get the heck out of here. Ooh, that's a little joy. See ya.